Hi guys, today let's try to build that cool animation using HTML and CSS. So this is gonna be very pure CSS tutorial, so we are not going to use any JavaScript here. Okay, this is my index.html file and this is the code editor, my index.html in the code editor, and this is my style.css file. So we are not using any script here. I'm closing it off. I'll get rid of these two lines also. So because this is a pure CSS tutorial, first we need to create a div with a class of particle. Okay, so before moving on that, as you can see, I have included the font awesome library here through CDN. Okay, fine, let's get started now. So inside the particle, let me remove this. So we are going to have 100 particles. This can be done with JavaScript, but I want to do it in the pure CSS way. That is the reason I'm using this. Okay, so div with the class of particle into 100, and inside the particle tag you'll be having a font awesome library icon, fa hyphen heart hyphen o. Okay, as you can see, we are having 100 particles here. Fine, so I'll click on save. As you can see, we are having the heart icons. Now we'll switch to style.css. So first I'll be writing some colors here. So the color list I'll be creating. Let me grab some random colors and paste it here. So these are the colors I'll be using in this list. Fine. So I'm using 10 colors. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten. So I'm using 10 colors here. Fine. So you can pick any random colors. On the body, we are targeting the body element. On the body element, first we'll write a transform style here. Transform style to be preserve 3D, and we'll set the background color of this body element to be GC. Okay, BGC. So I'm using pure black here, and I'll set the perspective to be some high value. Okay, as you can see, this is a black background, and right now we'll target the particle CLE. Let's copy the class from here. Okay, targeting the particle. Initially we'll set the height to 1 rem and also width to 1 rem. So I want to be a perfect square. That is the reason I am using both height and width as 1 rem. I am using the position to be fixed, and let me add the border so that it is visible. As you can see, this is the, let me resize the window. As you can see, this is our particle here. Okay, and we'll set the border radius on this element to some high 500 pixels. Actually, no need of border radius. Let's get rid of that. Okay, fine. Now we'll using a SAS for loop, $i from 1 through 100, because we are having 100 particles here. I'm writing from $1 to 100. Okay. So dot particle colon nth child of hash $i. That is, we'll be getting particle colon nth child of 1, nth child of 2, up to 100 particles there. Okay. First we'll generate a random number. So I'm using a variable here. The random number is generated using a SAS random function. Okay, and we'll target the icons inside the particle. So initially we'll set the color of these elements. So nth color list of, so I'm picking random colors from the colors list. So for this also I'm using a SAS functions here. So it just picks a color from this colors list and apply to the font awesome icon. Okay, so this is a variable here. So our color is the color variable we get from here. Okay, and similarly we'll apply some text shadow on these elements. The text shadow be 0 pixel 0 pixel 1 pixel dollar color. So I'm using multiple text shadows on this element. So let me duplicate this line several times. So max I'll be using 5 times here. 1 2 3 4 5. Okay, let's see. As you can see, this is right now the particle is this color. Okay, and for the animation what we are going to do is we are using a for loop here again for $j from 1 through 100. So at the rate keyframes, so the animation name be move out hyphen hash dollar j. That is, I'll be getting the move out hyphen 1 hyphen 2 hyphen 3 different keyframes there. So from the 0th position we want to animate to all the way to 100%. Okay, so initially we'll set the opacity to 0. We'll be playing the animation reverse. Okay, so random into 100% viewport width, that is the x value. Similarly y value going to be random into 100% viewport height. Okay, we'll apply some transform. So translate the elements $x and $y, and we'll translate the element to z via hash $j into 20 pixel, and we'll scale the elements hash $j into 0.1. okay, so I'm just picking the random values every time and applying them to the elements here. So in the 100th percent, here we'll apply some opacity. We'll set to 1, and we'll apply transform property again. We'll translate the element to 50% viewport width and 50% viewport height, and we'll translate via z. So basically we are preserving everything we applied from top. Okay, so initially it was 20, now it is into without 20 it is. Okay, we'll scale down to 0. Fine, so we need to apply the animation on these elements. So I'm applying the animation property, animation move out hyphen hash $i, and so this is going to be animation name. Let me write here, and we want it to be animated with random durations. So animation duration So animation duration is again the random number multiplies 10 seconds. So we don't want to animate all at a time. So we'll apply animation delay on these elements also. So the animation delay is again using the random number into 4 seconds. So let's save this. As you can see, all the elements are pushing inside. So let me remove the border on this element. So we don't want the elements to be pushed inside. So what we are going to do is we'll apply the animation direction to be reverse. Let me check here. Okay, seems some particles are not animating. Let me modify this from 0 to 100. Okay, seems there are some extra particles here. So initially we'll hide this element, and when I refresh, as you can see the animation taking place, but it is not looping. So initially we'll set the opacity to 100 and we'll add the animation iteration count to be infinite, and animation timing function is linear. Fine. So when I click on save, as you can see, this cool animation takes place here. Fine. Hope you enjoyed this video. Please do watch other videos on my channel. Please share and subscribe. Experiment with this. We'll meet again with an exciting tutorial. Take care.